here to help us understand what's really at the heart of this anger and rage is Senior Director of the Healthcare Innovation at the American Psychology Association, Dr. Vaile Wright. Dr. Wright, thank you so much for joining us. We just saw that story where this father, this man, was killed. I mean, this is escalating from people trying to record viral videos and shaming employees to killing someone. Is this really about a mask?
No, I don't think it's really about a mask. It's about this sense of when people feel like they're being controlled, they have a tendency to act out. It's not most people. It's a small group of individuals. Most people will just comply and go with it. But at its most extreme, when someone feels like they're being controlled, it may end up in illegal behavior or non-compliance with medical recommendations. And we know part of the things that actually influence this behavior is a lack of trust. In this case, a lack of trust in science and the government, as well as a lack of understanding of why they're being asked to do it and a lack of understanding of the person asking them to do it.
I guess, though, newsflash, every day of our lives, it's controlled. I mean, whether it's the speed limit, seatbelt laws, I am as rebellious as the next person. But we have to admit, every day, something is controlled. The FDA controls the food you get. Everything is controlled. Why this mask thing? Why has it turned into a level of rage? And I get distrust of a lot of things. But this, the kid is 24 at Starbucks. And you go into Starbucks, you know he doesn't own Starbucks. But yet you, I feel like you're punching at the person you think you can when that behavior is shown.
Yeah, I think there's a couple of things happening. One is the level of uncertainty that we're all experiencing during this pandemic is unlike anything we've ever experienced before. And so it's really causing a lot of negative emotions. And these negative emotions like frustration and anger and fatigue are driving the behavior. And when it comes to masks, I think what's unfortunately happened is it's become so politicized and connected to our identity in a way that other public health measures aren't, like wearing seatbelts.
Okay, but I hate to interrupt you, but I'm just looking at some of the social media feed things that are coming in. Somebody makes a point, no shirt, no shoes, no mask, no service. I grew up with signs at the convenience store, no shirt, no shoes, no service. I don't recall someone getting punched at the convenience store over that. And the other person wrote, regulations that they have to follow, including the face mask requirements, sanitation. So go take your business elsewhere. Why not go? Yes, the coffee might be good at that location, but you can find good coffee or buy the pod and make it at home. Why take a stand like Custer and lose in that Starbucks because the kid didn't get fired?
Yeah, again, because it's become attached to our values in a way that it doesn't need to be. It's really about protecting the public health. And instead, it's become attached to the sense of it's somehow infringing on my liberty in ways that hasn't. And that's been a result of a multiple of factors, including social media, as well as the inconsistent messaging coming down from leadership at multiple levels.